Hey guys, it's been a while since we've made a bento, so let's do it. I'm gonna make a quick and easy spicy tuna roll. In my bowl, I already have some canned tuna. For those of you guys that can't do like raw tuna, canned tuna is the way to go. Plus, you can pack it for lunch. To that, I'm gonna add a little bit of onions, just some minced onions. And if you guys saw my chopped onions video, I'm still using it. Next, I'm gonna add some garlic powder, some sriracha, a lot or a little depending on how spicy you can take it. Some QP mayo to give it that nice creaminess, sesame oil, and to bring out all the flavors, a little bit of rice vinegar. And finally, just a tiny drizzle of soy sauce to give it some saltiness. And then we mix, mix, mix. So I actually really love the option of using canned tuna here just because it's easier to pack for a picnic. And if you guys don't do raw fish, this is a really great option. And you get all the flavors. Give it a quick taste. This is good. I'm gonna set it aside and then we can start rolling. So here I have a sheet of toasted nori. I'm just gonna lay it down, and then I already made some sushi rice here. It's just very simple sushi rice, cooked it up with some water. But then I'm gonna add a dollop onto the nori and then just spread it out with my hands. And it helps when my fingers are slightly wet so that the rice doesn't stick. Just making sure it's a nice, thin, even layer all the way to the edge. Okay, and now what I'm gonna do is layer my toppings. I'm gonna use some green lettuce just because I like that crunch and the color it provides. Just put it down here. And then I'm gonna layer the tuna on the line right above. If it goes into the lettuce, that's okay too. And finally, a thin layer of carrots right on top. If you don't like carrots, you can always put cucumbers, avocados, whatever you want. And then now I'm just gonna roll it up. As I'm rolling, just make sure to press everything in. And I made sure to leave an inch of rice on top so that it could stick to the nori and give us a nice, yummy sushi roll like that. This one looks pretty round, but sometimes I like using a sushi mat right here to help guide it and like press it without breaking. I'm gonna set this aside and then we can make one more. This time I'm gonna start off with the sushi mat underneath if you need help guiding it along, just to give you guys some options. So to cut it, I usually like cutting it in the middle and then combining the two pieces together and then cutting them into thirds or quarters. This way you get really even pieces. So I'm gonna pack this into my beautiful Manbento original. It comes in two compartments like this and an elastic band to keep it secure. Just gonna pull the top lid off, and then we have an inner cup right here that I'm gonna show you what I'll do after I add our sushi slash kimbap in. Now we'll add the little food cup that comes with it. This can be used for soy sauce, for dipping, what have you, but today I'm gonna fill it with some vegetables. We have little mini peppers here and a cucumber. It's a bento, so we have to make it look aesthetic. So that is it for our first layer. I even have a Manbento sauce cup that I can fill with soy sauce to pack to go. Let's close it up. And I'm sure you guys are wondering, how does it taste? Let me tell you. The tuna has the perfect amount of creaminess and spiciness, and then paired with the crunchy carrots and lettuce, it's like fresh and flavorful. I love it. All right, so let's move on to our second layer of the bento. So the other week when I made the Japanese egg sando, you guys wanted me to make the fruit sando, so that is what we are gonna do today. I am gonna start with a large mixing bowl, and then to that I'm gonna add some really cold heavy cream. And as we're mixing it, I'm gonna sprinkle in some sugar. If you guys want the full measurements, I will have it written down in the description box below. And I just whipped it up until it became a nice thick cream like this. That way it's nice and stable when we add it to our sando. Okay, this is done. For the bread, I'm gonna be using this Japanese milk bread. You can find this at any Asian markets these days or at popular bakeries like 85 Degrees Cafe, Paris Baguette. If you can't find this, you can always substitute for good old white bread. I like brioche because it's a little more eggy too. The ones from Trader Joe's are really good, so that's always a great substitute. So here I have our bread laid out, and I'm gonna start with a nice thin layer of whipped cream. Spread it on our bread like butter, all the way to the edge. technically this is like sweet cream butter. Do you guys remember that project in grade school where you just add cream into a jar with two marbles and then shake it up and it becomes like this? So cool. If you don't have a mixer, you can always do that too. You get the same results. Okay, now that you have the layers of cream on the bread, we are gonna add our fruit. I have a combination of giant grapes or strawberries. I think I'm gonna do strawberries today. So the fruit sandwich is actually a little bit strategic. You have to know exactly where you put the fruit so that once you cut it up, it exposes the beautiful insides of the fruit. So I'm gonna lay my first one down horizontally, making sure to leave room so that I can cut off the crust. Add another piece of fruit. It could be anything. You can use a combination of strawberries, mangoes, grapes, kiwi, whatever you like. But I'm gonna do all strawberries here. And then because you're gonna have an empty spot here, I like filling it up with some more fruit. So I'm gonna cut these grapes in half and just fill in the gaps. You can fill the whole thing out here too, but I will just leave it as is. And then fold the other sandwich top over. Press it down gently, and then here comes the hard part. You actually have to wait for it. So I like wrapping mine in parchment paper tightly, and then I'll place it in the fridge for half an hour to let everything set and form. So here's our sandwich. It's been sitting in the fridge for half an hour, and it feels a lot more connected. I'm gonna remove the wrapper. And then I'm just gonna go through and cut all of the crust off. And I'm using a really sharp knife for this so that it can cut really clean. And look, we can already see the strawberry exposed, so it makes it a lot easier to cut it in half later. And now we'll just slice straight through our fruit and split it open. Ta-da, here's our dessert. I'm just gonna place it into our second layer of the bento. And I also went ahead and made a mini grape one, which I'm gonna place right here. And then to fill it out, we're gonna place a beautiful kiwi and add some extra fruit, strawberries, whatever you like. So let's build our bento. I'm gonna add our fruit sando layer on top. And then I also have this cool nifty cutlery set that sits right on top of the silicone tab. Close it up with a beautiful cap. I just love how pretty this is. It makes lunch so much better. And then to hold it all together, we have the Mon Bento elastic band that keeps everything nice and secure, and a matching water bottle to make lunch complete. If you guys are interested in getting your own set, I have a special promo code for you, which is Honeysuckle10, which you can use on their site from now until the end of September. I'll have the information in the description box below. Let me know in the comments section what you guys thought of the fruit sando and what fruit you would try, and if you guys would take this on a picnic, because I 100% will. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and give this video a like if you guys want to see more of my videos, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!